Hello guys, and welcome back to Phoenix Wright, Ace Attorney, Justice for All. In the last episode, if you don't remember, we went ahead and finished up the investigation, and we learned about the accident that took place 6 months ago, and in this episode, we're going to go ahead and get right back into the court sessions. Hopefully, this will be our last court day. Good morning, Max.
Oh, yeah. Good morning, sweeties.
You don't seem like your usual sparkling self today.
I'm always like this before I go in front of an audience. I'm working up to it.
Okay, I think I know who this is.
Tee-hee! Don't get nervous, Maxie. Here, have a glass of milk.
Regina!
Ah! How fabulous! My sweetie pie princess! You came to watch my performance today.
Of course I did. Mo told me that I should come and watch this.
Mo said that?
So, what kind of performance will you put on today? Let me guess, you'll fly at the end?
It's not that kind of show. Isn't that right, my sweeties?
Huh?
I think my sweetie pie princess doesn't...
Yeah, she doesn't seem to realize what's going on, or even where she is.
Well, Max, looks like it's time to raise the curtain. I'll see you later. Today I'm just a member of the audience.
Fabulous! Enjoy yourself out there.
Good luck, Max. You're the best.
Gina's different, don't you think, Nick?
Top of the morning to you! Everybody, let's get ready to get stuck in legal limbo. How low can you go?
Mo.
Top of the morning to you, Governor.
Top of the morning.
That's the ticket. Attacking the day starts with energy in the morning. The early bird gets the worm. But then again, worms lack higher brain function. Here, Max. I brought you a present. Have some milk.
Oh my. Thank you.
So, how are you today, Wright?
Well, I've got the feeling that today I'm going to face off against the real criminal.
You mean Acro?
Huh? You think he did it?
Be careful. He's used to putting his life on the line. Literally. He's got guts to spare.
If all I've got to worry about is how thin the tightrope is, I'm used to it already. It just means that I won't be able to press him like I can the other witnesses.
What are you gonna do then, Nick?
I guess today we'll just have to do without our usual psychological warfare. Today, we rely on evidence. It's the only way we'll get past Acro to the truth.
You're right, but it's gonna be tough.
Anyway, I want you to make sure that Regina sees it all today. It's important. Then she'll finally have to deal with the reality of what happened to her father.
You want us to make sure Regina watches?
Yes, that's why I brought her here to court today.
What's that supposed to mean?
She needs to know when people die they don't just become stars. I may be an old-fashioned clown, but I don't believe in people becoming stars.
From what I remember, this segment that we're in until the end of the case is like the best part of the case. Which isn't saying too much, but comparatively, this is definitely my favorite section of the case. Still does have some oddities here and there, but it's all around fairly solid.
The court is now in session for the trial of Maximilian Galactica.
The prosecution is ready, Your Honor.
The defense is ready, Your Honor.
Very well. Miss Von Karma, you may proceed with your case.
The prosecution would like to revise its previous theory of events.
What's the meaning of this?
We have discovered a new witness, or shall I say, a new eyewitness. One that saw Maximilian Galactica fly off from the scene of the crime.
Order! Order!
I had a feeling something like this would come up.
Due to this revision, we are now prepared to explain how the defendant flew that night. An explanation the prosecution will present if need so arises. In fact, my detective stayed up all night creating a mock-up of the scene, on my orders.
Poor Gumshoe.
Very well. Please call your witness to the stand.
Time to get to work. Or shall I say, time to walk the courtroom tightrope.
Name and occupation.
Ken Dingling, but everyone calls me Acro. I'm employed as an acrobat at the Berry Big Circus.
Where were you the night of the crime?
I was in my room that night.
If you look up at the map, you can see the witness's room is near the scene of the crime.
My room is on the third floor. The crime scene is below my window.
The night of the crime, the witness saw something quite shocking. Would you tell us what you witnessed?
Okay. Alrighty, Acro's first testimony. It was just after 10 p.m. and I was resting in my bed. Around that time, I heard a large thump noise from outside my window. Then a few moments later, I saw someone flying right by my window. It was Maximilian Galactica. I only saw him from behind, but that's who it looked like. To be honest, when I saw that, I thought I was dreaming. This witness's testimony matches up exactly with that of the clown.
If that's the case, there is very little the prosecution need add. All that's left is to explain how the defendant disappeared into the skies that night.
Before we get that far, I'd like to cross-examine the witness.
A foolish choice by a foolish fool who wishes to feel the foolish sadness of a sad fool. A man must know the proper timing for things, Mr. Phoenix Wright. Just like your old friend, Mr. Miles Edgeworth, did.
Mr. Wright, do you have a problem with the witness's testimony? In the words of Miss Vaughn Karma, may I quote yesterday's proceedings? There's no way that actually happened. Very well. You may proceed with your cross-examination.
You said that you were resting in bed. One would thus assume that you turned the lights off in your room, correct?
That's correct. But there are safety lights around the outside of the lodging house. It's so bright, sometimes it can make it hard to sleep.
If that's the case, wouldn't it be a good idea to close some curtains?
I never really thought of that. I guess that means I'm off to buy some curtains.
Sometimes I do make myself useful in these chambers. Ow!
The witness will proceed with his testimony.
Around that time, I heard a large thump noise from outside the window.
Your room is on the third floor, right?
Yes.
And you said that you were resting in bed.
That is correct.
You're still able to hear a sound from outside.
I was indeed.
Pressing Acro doesn't seem to get results. Maybe something was contradictory with what he just said. So, there's no contradiction here. I'm gonna say there's nothing wrong.
What's the matter, Mr. Wright?
Nothing, Your Honor. Until I can find a clear contradiction, I should tread lightly.
Then a few moments later, I saw someone flying right by my window.
Are you sure it was a human being? It could have been a mannequin, or perhaps a large action figure.
Well, setting aside the possibility of a mannequin, an action figure is plausible.
You have no need to mince words with Mr. Phoenix Wright. Testify to the truth and only the truth, just as if we were there with you that night.
I believe it was a human.
Damn. I just strengthened his testimony. I wonder if Acro's statement jives with the facts. I'm gonna say there's nothing wrong again.
What's the matter, Mr. Wright?
Nothing, Your Honor.
Okay, so it's just the same dialogue over and over again. So you get the gist of how this testimony goes. The important part here is right here.
It was Max Galactica. I only saw him from behind, but that's who it looked like.
You wanna press here? The light in your room was turned off then, right?
That's true. I was going to bed, after all. So, with the lights off, you were still able to clearly see a human flying by your window?
The safety lights lit things up enough for me to see. But honestly, there was only enough light for me to see the silhouette out of my window. It was the person's back, so I couldn't see the white roses on the front.
Did you see any of the other symbols?
I clearly saw the silk hat, as well as the cloak wrapped around his body. I'm convinced that the person I saw was Max Galactica.
The more I press him, the less results I seem to get. But maybe there is something fishy with his latest bit of testimony. For this one, there is a contradiction.
There is a huge contradiction with the testimony that was just given.
If there is a contradiction, then prove it with evidence.
She's right. Let's see some evidence. Do you have any evidence to support your claim of a contradiction?
Well, he says that when Max was flying up, he had his cloak hat on. But the cloak hat, or silk hat rather, not the cloak hat. I'm getting the symbols mixed up because we've had to hear that so many times. The silk hat, rather, was found at the scene, meaning he must have dropped it presumably before he started flying.
He claimed to have seen the exact same thing Mo saw that night. Do you stand by that?
What do you mean?
The silk hat.
What about the silk hat? I saw it on Max's head as he flew by my window.
Well, you should have tried looking down out of your window that night.
That would have been quite difficult considering the state I'm in. Just looking outside of the window was a tough enough challenge for me.
That's a shame, because if you would have noticed the silk hat found on the scene,
That's the Ringmaster's hat, right?
Afraid not. No matter how you look at it, this is Max's silk hat.
Where are you going with this, Mr. Wright? Are you saying that Max has two silk hats?
No. This is a handmade, one-of-a-kind model made only for Maximilian Galactica. Which means, Acro,
that you've been fibbing on the stand.
Order! Like always, someone has to open their mouth before sinking. Are you okay, Nick?
Well, I opened my big mouth and now I have to back it up.
How about it, Mr. Wright? What would cause this witness to commit perjury in this court today?
Well, the thing that Mo mentioned out in the defendant lobby, Acro is the real culprit.
Your Honor, on this occasion, the defense accuses Acro himself.
On this occasion?
Accuses Acro. What in the world are you accusing him of?
Obviously, we accuse him of the murder of Mr. Russell Barry.
Mr. Wright, are you serious?
Deadly serious, Your Honor.
I think your trips to the circus have served you well. You seem to remember how to try and grab at an audience's hearts and minds. Your Honor, don't allow yourself to be swayed by theatrics. Trying to rouse the crowd with smoke and mirrors is the oldest bluff in the book.
Really?
If you don't believe me, just look at the witness. He's calm enough for it to almost be scary.
He is staying rather calm and collected. I absolutely love that sprite of Phoenix being pecked at by the bird.
Mr. Dingling, do you have any response to the defendant's accusations?
I don't really need to say a thing, do I?
What do you mean?
Everyone, take a good look at me. I can't even stand up by myself, let alone leave the lodging house.
That's true.
I understand that Mr. Wright is trying to help his client. But to do this by accusing me of a murder of all things.
See? Even this...
Okay, a typo here. That's supposed to say,
even a sliver of common sense makes it clear that the accusation is ludicrous.
She's right. Way to go pick on the disabled, you heartless cruel man. Phoenix is a poopy head.
See that, Mr. Phoenix, right? If you're trying to drum up support from the Peanut Gallery, that's how you do it. I think that's enough of this little game. I have got a doctor's note to confirm that Akro is unable to stand under his own power. Maybe the defense is planning on making a claim to counter this as well. I can hear the defense now. Akro had an accomplice.
What do you say about this, Mr. Wright? Did Akro have an accomplice? Of course he didn't.
Now then, this must be when we get to hear the name of the mystery accomplice.
Not this time, Von Karma.
What?
You're not going to sucker me into this one. What are you blabbering about, Mr. Wright? There was no accomplice. Akro planned and committed this murder all by himself. Order. What are you getting at?
Way to keep them on their toes, Nick.
Now I'm gonna have to prove how all of it fits together. I have to show how Akro murdered Russell Berry.
Can you do it, Nick? Can you really do that?
I know what I can't do. I can't stop now. If I stop attacking, I'm doomed.
Alright, then let's do it. Mr. Phoenix Wright, if this witness is the killer, then his eyewitness account is all lies, right?
Mr. Wright, I'd like you to clear something up for me. When the crime was committed, where exactly was Mr. Dingling?
He was in his own room.
He was obviously here the entire time. That's Akro's room.
Pretty simple, eh? Akro wasn't able to leave the lodging house by himself. There's only one answer to that.
Akro didn't leave his room to kill the ringmaster.
What? Are you nuts?
What say you, Mr. Dingling?
It's an interesting theory.
And that's it?
Considering that what you proposed is impossible,
yes, that's it. Mr. Wright.
Yes, Your Honor?
As the witness has stated, your assertion is impossible. As he is in a wheelchair, there's no way he could go to the scene or be the killer.
You've got a point.
It seems you've forgotten once again, Mr. Phoenix Wright. The defendant was clearly spotted at the scene of the crime.
That's true.
Mo said that he saw Max, didn't he?
But Maya, it's still impossible for humans to fly. Do you mind if I ask a question, Mr. Wright?
What is it?
I understand some of your logic. However, how do you think that I killed him? If I can't leave my room, I obviously couldn't wear Max's costume.
How did he do it?
That's the next course of this legal buffet.
Be careful, Nick. If you mess up here...
She's right. I can't mess up here. I've got to give this one some serious thought. I'm sure that Akro killed the ringmaster. And he killed the ringmaster while he was in his room. No doubt about it. Time to enlighten us as to how Mr. Dingling committed the crime, Mr. Wright.
Let's go ahead and present some evidence.
I'm going to present some evidence. So, what did Mr. Dingling use to commit the crime of murder against Russell Berry?
The answer to that would be... Where is it?
The bust. What's that? A picture. He used a picture to commit the crime?
It is indeed. The problem is that the item that's shown in the picture.
The bust.
It's quite a large bust. Because it is life-sized, it is also very, very heavy.
Heavy?
Heavy enough to guarantee a certain death.
Especially if it was dropped from a third-story window.
Ah!
See? This is how Akro was able to kill the Ringmaster. With the force of gravity and Maximilian Galactica's ample bust.
Order.
So, you're saying that the bust fell onto the Ringmaster?
A rather simple crime. Even if you were stuck in a wheelchair, it would be incredibly easy to commit.
How could you possibly wheel a wheelchair with something so heavy? It's impossible.
Well, Akro is an acrobat.
He should have had more than enough upper body strength to carry something like the bust. Mr. Dingling, how do you respond to these charges?
Well?
Akra's at a loss for words. He should be. He knows that I'm getting close to the truth.
Well, 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 Akro. You can't run away from— Ow!
I'd watch what I say if I were you, Mr. Phoenix Wright.
What?
Your Honor, the physical health of the witness is material to this case. I demand that we get a proper testimony from the witness himself.
Testimony, you say?
Von Karma. He's just using this testimony as a ruse to stall for time.
There's absolutely no need for such testimony.
The defense has its version of the murder. The prosecution has the right to respond.
The defense's objection is overruled.
Why can't he see things my way once in a while?
Mr. Dingling, I'm sorry, but we need you to testify about your physical condition. If you have any doubts about your ability to testify, we can request expert testimony.
The witness will have no problems. However, let's all be respectful towards him.
Thank you.
Ugh, that woman will sink to any low to win a case.
Anyways, I think we'll hear this testimony about Akro's physical state in the next episode. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye!